Well, this is the aftermath. This held up pretty good. We put three-quarter inch with some of this flashing tape, a little bit of the tar on the back of the heat gun, and sealed it up and got virtually every bit of water out. Staggered the seams and screwed, put a ton of screws in it. And behind where we fastened it to the house, we put rolled foam that stuck to the 2x4, and it worked fantastic. Very strong. It's a tragedy on everything else, but it salvaged the inside of the house. Virtually no water got through, so we're really happy about that. But as you can see, the rest of it is. This was just all freshly done, you know, so. Not good, but it's better than it could have been. At least it didn't flush the house out again. It's probably not a bad way to go. I put hurricane fasteners into the house, so when we take all this off, we're going to number all these pieces and put them in the garage. But I think using this tape and the foam, anywhere where water can get in, even across the bottom, we put the foam. And this is, it took us a couple of days, but, you know, staggered the seams and put a million screws in it and put this on, but want to protect it. This seemed like it worked pretty good. You know, the hurricane shutters, these are pretty strong, but those can get ripped right out. So we got a game plan for next time. This worked really well. Hopefully we don't see this again for a long time, but maybe give you some ideas on how you want to waterproof the house. You know, these fasteners will still be in there, so if we just pop these off, take this off, pop the plywood off, we'll have all the pieces. It'll be a lot quicker next time. And it worked, you know, worked better than I thought it was going to. I had confidence in it, but, you know, the power of the ocean, you don't know. This held up pretty good. I just can't believe all the sand, you know. And then you have a beautiful day like this. You know, it's crazy. Mother Nature is brutal.